Zammad 6.1 has been released. Let's take a look at the new features and upcoming changes. We'll also talk about the deprecations after all the new fancy stuff. The ticket history has been improved. From now on, Zammad will tell you exactly what trigger, scheduler and postmaster filter did cause an update if it has been made by Zammad. This may feel minor, but actually is a great addition for researching issues with, for example, triggers. The history will be richer starting with this update, however, keep in mind that it will not affect existing history entries from before the update. For a very long time, people new to Zammad were confused what time unit the time accounting was in. That question will no longer be an issue. You can finally configure your own time unit that fits your company best. If you thought that's great, wait till I tell you about the optional activity types. This allows you to categorize each accounting step you take within your ticket. No matter if you have to give out a freebie or account to different branches, this is all now possible. Hurrah! Zammad supports SMIME for quite a while now. Finally, the long-awaited PGP support has landed as well. If you want to use this function, ensure that optional GNU-PG binary is installed on your server. PGP allows you to encrypt and sign your emails. Unlike SMIME, you don't require trusted certification authorities if you want broad support. Right now, just like with SMIME, you have to add trusted public keys of other users. You can also enable both variants if you want, however, you can only use one approach at the same time for outgoing emails. The following changes affect text fields only. Zammad now supports regular expressions in schedulers and triggers. This again makes triggers and schedulers drastically more powerful than they already were. Existing postmaster filters with regular expressions will automatically migrate to the new condition during upgrade. Also, you can now match specific words from a list by either using isAnyOf or isNoneOf. This greatly reduces chaining conditions or even may save you from using expert conditions. Last but not least, you can finally tell Zammad to match the beginning or end of a string from a word list by using starts with one off or ends with one off. Up to now, you could indicate that you have a VIP customer. However, the state would normally affect the organization instead of a single customer of the organization. You were forced to update all users with a VIP flag. Organizations now come with a VIP flag, allowing you to indicate a special organization. You can still flag your customers as important or even both. Within ticket zooms, Zammad will now prominently display the ticket customer and organization on top to guide you better. The VIP state will be shown for both the customer and the organization. In the ticket settings, administrators can now decide if the reassignment of the primary organization of a customer will also update the organization bound to the ticket. The 100 most recent tickets will be updated to the new organization. This is relevant if you require shared access based on the organization. Disabling this potentially makes tickets seem to be not existing for other users of the new organization. By default, Zammad will update the ticket organization of the customer. Some of you may recognize this little piece of hardware. This is a hardware key that can be used for two-factor authentication and other. Zammad supports hardware keys like YubiKeys or others. And any OTP app like Google Authenticator or any other fitting app you prefer. As a fallback, you will receive recovery codes in case you can't use your other second factor. If enabled, Zammad will request one of your second factors configured during the login phase. Administrators can even enforce the use of the two-factor based on specific groups. By default, Zammad will enforce the setting on the agent role. You may have to adjust your configuration. The two-factor authentication only works when using LDAP and login credentials. Zammad expects the third-party authentication to be secured already. As a reminder for Zammad 7, the following deprecations have already been announced. MySQL and MariaDB support will be removed. The Slack integration will be removed. If you're still using it, migrate to predefined webhooks instead. Internet Explorer 11 support will be removed with Zammad 7. With Zammad 7, as of now, the removal of the Twitter X channel is also considered. This is still an ongoing topic and highly depends on the API support up to that moment. You can learn more about the reasons in the documentation of Zammad. With Zammad 6.1, the Unicorn web server support has been removed. This should only affect source code installations, if any. It hasn't been officially encouraged for years. Starting with Zammad 6.2, package support for the following distributions will be removed: Debian 10, Ubuntu 18, and /12. If you're still running Zammad on these distributions, consider upgrading or better migrating to a new system. Okay, that's about it. What's your favorite new function of Zammad 6.1? Let me know in the comments. Until next time, take care.